Hello students, welcome to the lecture series of fluid mechanics. In our last lecture, we have learned about very important topic, that is velocity triangle, right? In our today's lecture, we will learn about impact of jet on series of flat plate as well as series of curved plate. So let us derive the first theory, impact of jet on series of flat plate. Or they can ask you impact of jet on series of flat plate. In that case, efficiency will be 50%. Clear? So let us draw sketch here. This is one wheel where flat vanes are mounted. From nozzle, jet is coming with velocity v, and here u is equal to, as usual, velocity of blade, right? Now impact of jet on single blade is only a theoretical one. We have learned various cases regarding single blade, but in actual day-to-day life, there is no any single plate in any type of machine. So there are large number of plates which are mounted on the circumference of wheel. So for it, let us take force. So first of all, force is equal to, as usual, mass flow rate into change in velocity. So here force is equal to mass flow rate. Here mass flow rate is rho a v. Now question arises, sir, this is moving plate, so why we are not taking here rho a v minus u? But here there are so many vanes. Suppose 60% fluid are impact on the this blade, so remaining 40% fluid are not wasting, it will be acting or it will be impact on this blade. So we have to take fully rho a v. Now initial velocity after impact at this point, initial velocity will be relative, that means we have to take v minus u. After impact, there is no velocity in that direction, that means velocity will be zero. So we can write rho a v, v minus u as a force. Now for work done per second, as we have remember, work done per second is force into velocity of blade. So force rho a v, v minus u into velocity of blade u. From the equation of efficiency, we can also say efficiency, that means output by input. Let us revise here. Output is work done per second in the case of impact of jet, but input is kinetic energy per second. That means 1/2 mv² is kinetic energy. If we divide m by second, that means mass flow rate. So we can write 1/2, that is mass flow rate rho a v and v square. From this equation, rho a, this v got cancelled, so remaining is efficiency of blade is 2u v minus u divided by v square. This is efficiency of blade in case of series of blades. Here we have to derive equation for condition of maximum efficiency. So from the equation of efficiency, we can also say this efficiency depends on u and v only. There is only two parameter which are affecting on efficiency. So first of all, u is blade velocity. Now blade velocity is nearly constant. We cannot change blade velocity by itself, but we can also change jet velocity from outer side of the turbine or any type of a jet. So this is remaining constant, small u. So we can derive it equation with respect to capital V, that means jet velocity. So now let us take condition for maximum efficiency. So for maximum efficiency, efficiency derivation with respect to dv is equal to zero. Here remember, u term is taken as a constant. So del by del v, 2u v minus u into divide by v square is equal to zero. Here after simplification, d by dv, 2u divide by v minus 2u square by v square is equal to zero. Let us take small u component as a constant and take it outside for the derivation. So we will get small u is equal to capital V by 2 with the derivation of it. It is very simple derivation, right? So this is condition for maximum velocity. If you want to write a statement, then we can write for the series of flat blades, maximum velocity will be occurs when blade velocity will be half of the jet velocity. That means your jet velocity is 100, so in that case blade velocity must be 50 for attaining maximum velocity. city. Clear? If you want to find how much amount of maximum velocity we can find, so if you put this value u is equal to v by 2 in our main equation of efficiency, then you will get efficiency maximum is equal to 50%, right? That means if we use series of flat blades, we can find 50% as a maximum efficiency. So let us revise this. So impact of jet on series of flat plate mounted on a wheel. That means first of all, you have to find force. From the force, you can find work done per second. That means power. From the power, you can find equation of efficiency. From the equation of efficiency, we have to find maximum efficiency. So we have to determine the parameter which are affecting on efficiency. So there is only two parameter, jet velocity and blade velocity. Here blade velocity is nearly constant, so we have to derive it with respect to jet velocity. After derivation, we will get small u jet velocity, small u is equal to v by 2. That means blade velocity is half of the jet velocity for maximum efficiency. If we put this condition u is equal to v by 2 in our efficiency equation, then we will get maximum efficiency is 50%. Dear students, so let us move on next theory and last theory of this chapter, impact of jet on series of radial curve when mounted on a wheel. Previous theory is about flat blade, but this is a radial curve blade. In real life, in any type of a turbine, only radial curve blades are used. So this is very important and basic theory with regards to turbine. So let us understand sketch first. So first of all, from the sketch, this is radial blades. First one, second, and third. Velocity, here now we already know about velocity triangles. Student, remember it? Okay. Then we have to draw velocity triangle because this is curvature blade and fluid is coming at a tangentially direction and blade is also moving. So here that is wheel inner diameter, wheel outer radius, R1 is outer radius, R2 is inner radius of the wheel, O is radius of the wheel. Now velocity of jet is coming from this direction V1. We have already derived it. So first of all, we have to draw V1, then we have to convert U1 from blade velocity to here. After V1 and U1, we have to draw VR1. Then let us take two components of V1. Which are two components of V1? Flow velocity and wall velocity. So here it is vertical flow velocity and horizontal wall velocity. Alpha 1 will be angle between velocity of jet and velocity of blade. So V1 and U1 between alpha 1. And beta 1 is the angle between relative velocity and velocity of blade. So VR1 and this velocity of blade, that is known as beta 1. If the blade is moving, if the fluid is moving VR1, then at the outer section, first we have to draw VR2. Then we will transfer this U2 from here to here according to velocity triangle. So VR2 and U2 will be there. Here direction of the velocity is most important because velocity is the vector quantity, right? So in the triangle of U2, V2 and VR2, V2 is always resultant. So from initial to final point, we have to connect V2. So after U2, V2 and VR2. Now let us take components of V2. So vertical component VF2 and horizontal component VW2. Here direction of VW2 is in the left hand side. So we have to take it as a negative. Okay students, so inlet and outlet velocity triangles can be drawn as per this sketch. Now here R1 is equal to inner side radius of the vane, that means inlet radius of the vane. Here inlet is from this point, so this is known as inlet radius. Similar way, R2 is outlet radius. V1 is velocity of the jet at inlet, V2 is velocity of the jet at outlet. Omega, here the blade is rotating, so we have to take angular velocity instead of total velocity. Now U1 is equal to velocity of vane at inlet, blade velocity at inlet. Now from the equation, U is equal to R omega. So U1 is equal to R1 omega. Here U2 is equal to R2 omega. In earlier case, we can write U1 is equal to U2. But in this case, R1 is not equal to R2, so we cannot write U1 is equal to u2. Clear? So in this case, u1 is not equal to u2. Let us take derivation of it. So first of all, from this sketch, in the earlier case, we have taken work done by z is equal to force into velocity. But this is rotating body, so we have to take torque instead of force, and we have to take angular velocity instead of simple velocity. So first of all, let us find torque and angular velocity. Then after, in that case, there is force is equal to rate of change of momentum. In this case, instead of force, we have to write torque is equal to rate of change in angular momentum. So first of all, we have to find angular velocity, then we can find angular momentum, and then we can solve angular momentum equation. So first of all, according to momentum equation, at the tangential direction at inlet side, mass flow rate into component of velocity is equal to momentum. Clear? You have to remember it, capital M momentum is equal to mass flow rate into velocity. So at the inlet, mass flow rate is rho a v1. So rho a v1 into component of v1 in x direction. So here it is v1, so component of it in x direction, that means this component. So we can write v1 cos alpha 1. So v1 cos alpha 1. But from this sketch, v1 cos alpha 1 is this, and vw1 is also this. So we can write v1 cos alpha 1 as vw1. So at the inlet, rho a v1 vw1 will be momentum, right? So what do you mean by angular momentum? So for angular momentum, we have to multiply radius. So equation of momentum into radius at inlet, that means here r1. So that is called our equation number 1. For the outlet side, mass flow rate is also rho a v1, because the once the mass is entering here, it will be converted into outlet mass. So rho a v1 and the component of v2 in tangential direction. So v2 is here. So component of v2 is this much, v2 cos b alpha 2 in negative direction. From the sketch, v2 cos alpha 2, that means vw2. So here we can write rho a v1 into minus vw2. So for angular momentum at outlet, we have to simply multiply momentum into radius at outlet. Here from this sketch, we have to take correction here. Rho a v1 is the mass, right? So here minus rho a v1 vw2 into r2. From angular momentum equation, torque is equal to net rate of change of angular momentum. That means angular momentum at inlet minus angular momentum at outlet. If we put angular momentum for inlet and outlet in this equation, from this here v1, right? From this rho a v1 got common, so vw1 r1 plus vw2 r2 is torque. So properly work done is equal to torque into angular velocity. Remember, in the earlier case, work done is equal to force into velocity. So in this case, instead of force, we have to take torque, and instead of velocity, we have to take angular velocity. So torque into angular velocity. So here it is torque, and angular velocity is omega multiplied inside. So rho a v1 vw1. Now omega r1, that is known as velocity u1, and omega r2, that is known as velocity u2. So for general cases, we already know about it. It is alpha 2 less than 90. So in equation, there will be a plus. If alpha 2 is equal to 90, there is no any vw2. So this term will got cancelled. And if alpha 2 greater than 90, then in equation there will be a minus. So for general cases, we can also write rho a v1 vw1 u1 plus or minus vw2 u2. Clear, students? Then after, let us take equation of efficiency. So particularly efficiency, that means work done divided by time divided by kinetic energy per time. So work done divided by time, that means rho a v1 vw1 u1 plus or minus vw2 u2, and in kinetic energy, 1/2 mass flow rate into velocity square. So we can directly write 1/2 rho a v1 cube. From simplification, efficiency for the curved blade is 2 times vw1 u1 plus or minus vw2 u2 divided by v1 square. Here for alpha 2 less than 90, there will be a plus value. Here alpha 2 is equal to 90, so this term got cancelled, and alpha 2 greater than 90, so there will be a minus term between. So let us revise this theory. In this theory, there is a rotating curve blades in which r1 and r2 radius are different, so we cannot write u1 is equal to u2. So first of all, we have to find efficiency. For efficiency, we have to find work done per second. For work done, in old case, we have taken force into velocity, but in this case, we have to take torque into angular velocity. So instead of force and instead of impulse momentum equation, we have to show torque momentum equation or angular momentum equation. So first of all, angular momentum at inlet and angular momentum at outlet. Here you have to correct this one. At outlet, mass flow rate is also rho a v1. So we can find angular momentum at inlet and outlet. Put the angular momentum equation in this equation. So torque is equal to rate of change of angular momentum. So here we have torque. Now work done is equal to torque into angular velocity. So we have work done. From the work done, we can derive equation for efficiency. Clear, students?